Some guys just don't like one stuck in their face. Oh, is he gone? Yeah, there's the edge being given. And I think he knows. I think he stood there to see if he get away with it. And there's a faint tickle and there's a real ooze and sighs around the ground because it's the end of Evan Lewis.
There we go, the left-arm spinner getting the left-handed batter. Oh, this was different. It was slower, it was wider up the off stump. And it's fun. It's a good catch from Azam Khan. But a lovely change of pace, line, and length from Motie. 48 to Evan Lewis, 83 for three.
Love spin. You will capitalize on anything with length.
Yeah!
Again, six and then wickets. And Motie does it again. Holds his nerve beautifully.
Might have just picked Ambati Raidu, leaving his crease a little bit early. The very best bowlers are able to make last-minute subtle adjustments to their initial plans. Motie showing his true class and getting this very, very important wicket and giving more control to the Warriors.
For six. Gudakesh Motie is too good.
Indeed, not a part of the West Indies T20 international team in the recent series against India. Surely you would think that he's got the quality, the class, the skill set to play in that format at the international level. And he reinforces his class, not only in ODIs, but in T20Is and in T20s. Third wicket for Gudakesh Motie, that of Corbin Bush, gone for eight.
Good luck to teams when this tournament gets to Trinidad and Guyana, where I keep saying they'll play six of their 10 games. Another one. Four for Motie. History. And the Warriors are marching on.
A performance of note from the left-arm spinner. Prides himself on his ability to control his lengths, to bowl wicket to wicket, and to turn the ball as well. Left-arm spinner from Burmese Guyana, doing the business for the Warriors, and now etching his best figures in the Republic Bank CPL. Kofi goes for seven, 126 for eight.